All right, guys, so in today's video, we're gonna do another clothing brand promo video breakdown. Now, I've done clothing brand videos over the past few years, and there's always things to learn within every video that you did. So today, I really wanna give you guys some advice, some tips that I learned throughout this video, and also really just, you know, break it down in case you guys are looking into shooting your own clothing brand video. So let's go ahead and play the video. We'll come back, give it a breakdown, talk about some tips and advice, and we'll call it a day.
Woo! Me voy a poner una peda. ¿Estás lista?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, me too.
Oh my god. What you doing on this side? Do you know where you at? Let me give you some advice before you get too attached, baby. Don't get caught up in the lies, cause you won't never make it back. Cause this city, this town, is so much more than that. Baby, do you feel like surfing on the waves? Ooh, baby, now we can freak it from Hollywood up to the Bay. Ooh, yeah. Let me show you what that was like. Alright, baby, won't you come and ride with me?
So now you guys watch the video, go ahead and leave a comment below. Let me know what you guys think about it. What did you guys like? What did you guys not like? Drop it a like if you guys did like it, hopefully. So let's just continue with this video. Let's go ahead and talk about a few breakdowns, a few things that I can give you guys as far as shooting these clothing brand videos. So let's get started with the first tip of the day today, and that is to scout your client. So what I mean by that is, when there's a client that comes at you within your social media platforms and they want a promo video done, right? The number one tip that I can tell you guys is scout the client that's coming at you. Look at the past videos or photos that they've done. So obviously, if they're coming at you for videos, specifically just look at their videos. Look at the style that they have, you know, basically the lifestyle that they're providing. Also, look at the edits that they've been doing. See how you guys can bring better value to their videos. See how you can, you know, be an upgrade compared to the one that they have. Because if they've done multiple videos in the past, you know, you definitely want to look at that, and you definitely want to provide something more than that. You don't want to be another filmmaker from their past. You want to retain that client. So look at their past videos, try to, you know, provide something better so you guys can maintain that client and keep the client to work going forward. So now number two on this video that I want to break down is a storyline. This clothing line that she was releasing, it was around Mexican Independence Day. So, you know, I definitely wanted to show a little bit of like everything that involved in that circle, right? I wanted people to feel that lifestyle. I wanted to implement the Loteria, the pit bull that was there, you know, the drinks, literally, like, you know, I'm Hispanic, so I know what it's like on a west side where, like, you know, people get together in the backyard, make a little party, you know, they drink. So I just really wanted to implement that type of lifestyle. So I kind of knew what I was going to go for. And doing these type of lifestyle videos, of course, shout out to Ruby Knows, because she actually provided me with a mood board and everything in order for me to basically go in there with a purpose. So just having that, this like story lifestyle, it's different. These lifestyle storyline videos, it's a lot more engaging, and you're kind of really providing what the clothing brand is about. It's not really just a promo video. There's more to it, and it's more powerful. It grabs like the audience that the client wants to grab. Now, the third tip that I can tell you guys is have a set time with this client. So for example, with Ruby, when she reached out to me, you know, there was a certain budget that she had, and so I was like, okay, for that type of budget, I could only do 2 hours for this video. And with that, you know, when I showed up, she had everyone already ready to go when I got there, and then of course, you know, we started shooting, and I could have got everything done within the 2 hours, but Ruby actually ended up being a real cool person, and I actually ended up staying there for 4 hours. Now, I didn't shoot for 4 hours. I was drinking, I was chilling with them, you know, eating that wok, eating that salsa. It was a good time. But what the benefit of providing these 2 hour gaps, or like just giving them a time frame, is A, they're able to respect you as a creator. They're not going to take advantage of you. You have a set time. Now, if they're cool people, then you sure, go ahead and, you know, stay that extra hour or two if you want. But at least you had a frame where they can like basically respect your time. And if they're being hard to work with, then the 2 hour mark you gave them, and you can just walk away. So you're kind of looking out for yourself so you don't get taken advantage of. And, you know, so setting a time frame is always good. I know sometimes it's kind of hard, but again, if they give you a mood board and there's a lifestyle like this, you really know what it takes to get it done. All right, so now tip number four, three, something like that, is to go ahead and capture organic for these clothing brand videos. You don't want it to be so serious, depending on obviously the lifestyle and the story that you're providing for the clothing brand. So for this particular video, you know, it was all fun. You know, you notice how everything looked raw, authentic, and that's because it was. Basically, before we started shooting, you know, we all talked, everyone was talking, and all I really said was, look, we're gonna film section to section to section, but when I get to your section, go ahead and pretend the camera's not there. Now, if there's something that I see from any one of you guys that I like, I'm gonna go ahead and have you redo it. But for the most part, I wanna capture this as organic as possible. But obviously there was times where I saw something happening and the, you know, the vibe and the energy was there, when I just basically went up to him like, can you do that again? And I want everyone around to do the same thing they were doing. So by you telling them that, they're just gonna be doing their thing. And then whenever you wanna stop it, you have the option of doing that and getting the shot that you saw that you liked. And now the last tip, again, I'm losing numbers. I don't know if it's 3, 4, 5. For sure it's not 3, 4, or 5, we'll go with that. But the last tip for this video is to not make any excuses when it comes to the weather conditions of this video. And see, that's what separates a good creator to a bad creator. So a good creator, we understand sometimes shooting in harsh lighting is not the best, right? Because like it could look bad. But as a great creator actually, you gotta learn how to maneuver around the harsh lighting. So maybe shooting them in the shade, or maybe you do wanna utilize the harsh lighting because it provides a certain look that enhances the video. So, you know, you don't always have to shoot in sunset. You don't always have to shoot in a cloudy weather or anything like, you know, that we all love to have. It helps, obviously, colors look better. Dynamic range is a lot better for our cameras. But you gotta learn how to move around and, of course, you know, move direct shots. So there was an instance where, you know, I was shooting one way and I basically reset the shot and told him, can we do it again? But this time I'm gonna shoot it pointing this way because the light is in my favor. Now, obviously it's still harsh, but again, it's having to work with what it is. Now, this is a West Coast kind of like clothing brand, you know, Mexican Independence Day style lifestyle. So what I wanted to do was just really provide that. You know, when you're showing up in a backyard boogie with a bunch of Hispanics, man, it ain't perfect. Everything's just fun, raw, authentic, and it's just going crazy. And you know, really, we shot this, I think, like 4 p.m. All the shots really were captured, as you guys saw, in bright, harsh lighting. And it comes to just working around it. Not everything has to be in the best weather. Keep that in mind. I know we all like that, but again, there's ways to implement harsh lighting. It's not always sunset or overcast. You know, just shoot with and work around that. Stop making any excuses. I see too many creators nowadays wanting that perfect lighting. And sometimes it's just, you know, it just doesn't work out like that, or we don't have that flexibility of having the sun drop when we want it to. So just shoot away and just have fun. So shout out to Ruby Notes for, you know, choosing me to make her video. That shit was fun. It was lit. So you guys watched all those Modelos. I was drinking them. No, I'm just playing. But I did have a few. She did offer some. She offered me guacamole salsa. So if you guys are actually people trying to hire a videographer, make sure you guys treat them with some food. You know, the more you guys treat them with food, especially me, but maybe other creators are like me, the more you treat them right, they're gonna make a better video. They're gonna put more work into it because you're treating them right. So this is a tip for anyone that's trying to hire a videographer. But yeah, anyways, that's an extra bonus tip. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Hopefully you guys like it. Let's play that video one more time and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.
Woo! Me voy a poner una peda. ¿Estás lista?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, me too.
What you doing on this side? Do you know where you at? Let me give you some advice before you get too attached, baby. Don't get caught up in the lies, cause you won't never make it back. Cause this city, this town, is so much more than that, baby. Do you